So, in our first talk of the day, Yuichiro Sato will discuss his work on the application of inductive logic programming to transfer learning from tic-tac-toe to more complex Connect 4 and 5 games in particular and general game playing in general. Thank you.
So, I will talk about transfer learning by inducting logic programming. So first, I will introduce about transfer learning, a purpose of this research, and general game playing, a framework of this research, and inductive logic programming, a tool of this research. Then, I'll talk about generalization of generation of heuristic functions for alpha beta search by inductive logic programming, and performance of the transfer learning. So transfer learning. For human, once this guy learns the easy games, like tic-tac-toe, then guy easily learn complex games, like Connect 4 or Connect 5. So because they exist same patterns. So human can transfer some knowledge from easy games to complex games. So, what I want to do is make it possible to the same learning process for computer. To do that, I used GGP, General Game Playing, as a framework. So, General Game Playing is a research topic to create general game player, which can play general games, it means discrete, finite, and perfect information games like chess, Japanese chess, shogi, go, something, puzzles. So these kind of games, so general game player can play all of these games. And so this is how to play general game player with general games. So first, general game player needs game description. So game description is written by GDL, game description language. This is given from game master, some kind of server. And once game description is given for the player, this player loads the description to the reason. This is a GDL reason. So this reasoner simulates the game. So and when this player given current position is given for this player, so this player to simulate this game and do some kind of search and so find a good move and reply to the game server. So and opponent does the same thing and so general game player can play the general games. And this is the framework of my research. And so this is the tool of my research. So IoT, inductive logic programming. So suppose there exists 10 of trains. So these 5 is positive examples. And these 5 are negative examples. So what is the difference between positive and negative examples? So these 5 are different. But for human, it's difficult to see. But IoT tool knows the answer. So to use IoT tool, so situation need to be described by logic programming, like this way. So this logic says so train 1 has a curve such that this curve, so train 1, this one has a curve, so short curve and long curve and open curve and so on. So when the all the examples, all trains are written by this way, then put these logics to the IoT tool. I used earlier. The IoT tool generates the the most general description of the situation. And in this example, so this proposition is generated. So positive example has occurred such that short and not. So let me see. So this is a positive example, and so this train has a short and close curve, and this is also. So all positive example has a short and close curve. And for negative examples, so there's no short and close curve, no. So it means this proposition is true for all the positive examples, but not true for all of the negative examples. So that is why this is a most general description of the situation. So this is good. This is nice proposition. If I give good positions for a game as a positive example, and bad position of the game as negative examples, then I need to give me the some propositions which is only true for the good position of the game and not true for the bad position of the game. So that must be good heuristics for the game. So To use IOP tool, I need some logic problems. So in other words, background knowledge. So it is able to generate some kind of context from tic-tac-toe game. So context means some kind of pattern. So this is a tic-tac-toe position, and it is able to write this position by logic. And so this means a cell 1-1, so here's the O, and so here's a blank, so blank, and so on. So from this proposition, it is able to create those concepts. So just replacing symbols and numbers to variables and some calculations, then it is able to make such general concept. So for example, so concept one came from here. So just replace here and here to a variable, here and here to a variable, and this is add two plus one is three, so just replace it to some calculation, then the concept is generated. So and it came from here, so it is able to generate some other concepts. So for example, here is a diagonal line, so this is so three pieces are involved. This is some conjunctions of logic. And so I created 81 conjunctions from 2,000 of random game simulation of tic-tac-toe. And also I generated a disjunction from 2,000 of tic-tac-toe simulation with a winner. So it means 17 conjunctions which is generated from here. It needed to describe the 2,000 of tic-tac-toe simulation with a winner. And so I use these conjunction and disjunctions as a background knowledge. So now it is able to generate heuristic functions. So put concepts which I generated just and put play out this with win and put play out with loss to IOP2. Then IOP2 generates the most matching concept to win and not to lose. So it will be a good heuristic. And this is an example. from 20 of positive and negative examples of connect four, I got these specialized concepts. So these guys are, so I repeated concluded these patterns are useful to win for connect four. And I think this is not obvious for anyway, I will teach you concluded. And I did the same thing for different example size. So what I showed is here. Yeah, so 20 examples, and I got 5 specialized content. So if I get 10 of examples, 10 of positive and negative examples, so only 3 specialized concepts are obtained. So it means if I give more and more examples, then I will be able to deploy more and more specialized concepts. And so this is for the disjunction. So disjunction, which I made a disjunction with 17 conjunctions, and actually 3 of them is actually used for 10 of examples. And so this is for connect 4. And I did the same thing for connect 5, and I got the same tendency. And but for connect 5, I use the conjunctions which is used in this specialization. So it means for this computation time. And I got 30 to 20 node set of specialized concepts. So I made a heuristic for each set of specialized concepts. I made a heuristic. So I got 15. So let's test. So performance was tested by a beta player with heuristics against with random game player or alphabet player without heuristics. Not connect 4 and connect 4. And this is results for connect 4. So game is against with random game player. And this is a result of such steps 1. Such steps is fixed at 1. And this is the result of such steps is fixed at 3. And for this, there looks no improvement. But for here, there is an improvement. So it means knowledge transfer succeeded. But obtained heuristics is not perfect heuristics. So in the middle of the game, it's useful, but end of the game, it is not useful. That is why, due to the substeps, so result is get different. It get different. And rhythm ratios going up. So it means if I give more and more examples to the IRP tool, then it requires better and better heuristics. So this is also a good situation. So transfer learning working well. Looks like well. So and this is the result of also this is for connect 4, but against with one depth alphabet player. And there looks the same tendency, but only for the conjunctions because of the computation time. And this is also this is for connect 5. But this is only for random game player of connect 5. And so there looks a little improvement around here. So bigger example, if I give a lot examples, then it's slightly better than the exact choices. So, and so this is only, I only did subtext one. I want subtext three simulation, but it was, I couldn't because of the simulation, yeah, computation time. So this means, in my heuristics, all combination of pieces on position is evaluated. So this is the limit of my approach, I think. So conclusions, transfer learning is observed, successfully observed from tic-tac-toe to connect 4 and connect 5. And then two more. So general game player can play many games, at least over 10 of the games, but what I did is only 3. I think this is the Connect 4 and Connect 5, that is the most complex game which IOP is useful. And this is my conclusion.
Questions?
So I have a question. I have the impression that the transfer learning that you have is for basic heuristics and for basic patterns. How do you have an idea how this could be more general, that it goes for even more complex patterns for other games?
Other games. Yes. So what I did is tic-tac-toe and connect 4 and connect 5. It's just a simple game. So if I put a stone on the position, then the stone never moves. And if so, in many games we can move the pieces, and maybe we can capture pieces, and some pieces has the different roles. So I need to recognize the GDL, so the game description language. I need to analyze the game description language, and I need to recognize the which role the piece has. So if I do such analysis, then it is able to use maybe ILP or another evaluation techniques to play more complex games. And also I can transfer some analysis for easier games to complex games. So what do I need is analysis of GDL. Or maybe the semantic, I need to analyze the semantics of the GDL.
Yeah, I would say if you change the board size of the game, then a lot of the ideas would carry forward, I think, to the new board size. Or, I mean, if you had ideas about how to play chess, you could play mini chess or Fischer Random chess. And the ideas would go across in some way. And you'd want to identify those higher level ideas so that they transcended the board size somehow.
I hope it works, but now it's difficult because to do that, I need to analyze the load of the pieces and so. In mini shogi, mini chess, so maybe pieces are differently organized in the initial positions. So I need to know which pieces correspond to the other games. So,
my question, is there an opportunity here for man and machine working together through this language,
For me, it is possible.
For the higher level ideas get generated by the human and then are expressed easily in ILP, is that a possibility? Or is the computer doing everything?
Maybe possible.
Yeah.
also have a question, as a subsequent question to Hayward's question. That is, if we change the board size,
yes,
that's fantastic, of course. But then, if we look at the objective point of view, the game could change its nature. For instance, if we have tic-tac-toe and we have 9 squares, and we add 1 square, so we have tic-tac-toe with 10 squares, then we know it is a win for the first player. Yes. So that is one point. How do you handle that? And the other point is, you said that you could construct heuristic functions from tic-tac-toe to connect four. As you know, connect four has been solved. Do you think that by your generation of heuristic functions, you can find a set of heuristic functions which solve the game of connect four?
Research to improve such technique, and so for first question, yes, some only a slight change, change of rules, changes all of the game could be, but anyway, heuristics is some part of heuristics is useful, maybe for two of the ten of tic-tac-toe, so you can use the same heuristics. So you need to anyway you need to search to solve the game, and so you can also, you can use the same heuristics to solve the different type of tic-tac-toe, and so.
And the second question, because the arbiter is.
No, keep going. We'll get the next computer set up.
Let's solve the game. We don't need to research for the solve the game. But anyway, this it's a good test bed for heuristics. So that is why
Okay. Thank you for the answers, yes.
Thank you.